need is some yellow and some orange and brown. Bit of white there. You're watching BBC One Wales. Oh, you're new. I'm on a wonderful Welsh adventure as I discover more about four outstanding artists influenced by this great land. During the series, I'll be creating paintings inspired by their work. I'm going to have to paint in ways I've never done before. And at the end of it, I'll probably turn to you and I'll say, can you tell what it is yet? Leaving the mainland behind, crossing Menai Strait, heading for the island of Ynysmorne, in English, Anglesey. It's an island that's crammed full of spectacular scenery, and it certainly was the inspiration for one of my favourite artists, Sir Cuffin Williams. In my humble opinion, Sir Cuffin Williams is the best artist Wales has ever produced. His work is hugely popular, not just here, but in places where they've never ever seen a Welsh farm or a sheepdog. Cuffin was born in 1918 in Llangefni, which is just a few miles from here. But despite the fact that he was an art teacher in London for many, many years, all he ever wanted to do was get back here and paint Wales. And who can blame him? I knew Cuffin and felt a real connection with his dramatic paintings. But as much as I love his landscapes, some of my favourites are actually his paintings of people. And with great trepidation and more than a little fear, I'm going to paint a portrait in his style as a tribute to a great man. If I'm to get to grips with Cuffin's style, I really need to revisit the people and places that mattered most to him. Although Cuffin lived in London for 30 years, he only made it big as a painter when he was in his 50s, following his return home to North Wales. There's an old saying that every Welsh home should have a harp in the corner and a Cuffin Williams on the wall. Well, there were plenty of Cuffin's paintings on the walls here at this old cottage where he used to live when we visited him. It's right opposite the Menai Strait. My wife and I had admired his work for many years, and not only was he a great artist, but he became a very dear friend, and I had the privilege of painting his portrait just before he died. I'm so proud that Cuffin liked my finished portrait of him sitting in his favourite armchair. Cuffin never married, he simply lived for his art. But how did a boy who was born into a family of country vicars become a celebrated international artist? Well, I do know that during the Second World War, he ended up at one of Britain's top art schools, the Slade, after epilepsy ended his military career.
Why the Slade? Because an army doctor had advised me in his wisdom, Williams, you should do something that doesn't tax the brain. Try art. After the war, I shared my time between teaching in Highgate School, London, and Wales. Every spare moment was spent in Wales, sketching constantly and painting, at least two canvases a week, sometimes one a day.
When Cuffin moved back to his beloved Anglesey in 1974, his great patron and close friend Lord Anglesey converted this cottage and studio for him. Cuffin never left. And for the next 30 years, until his death in 2006, the Marquis remained a guiding light in his life and career. It's great to share memories, as the Lord rarely gives interviews.
I think we can say now with certainty that in 50 years, say, people will acknowledge that he, at this at the period of his life, was the great artist in Wales. And he was not in any way, aren't I great?
No.
Until, of course, he got his knighthood. And then was utterly like a boy, he was so delighted with it. he was a great man. He was a great man and a great artist. He was mad keen on artists who took the trouble to actually draw. Those who didn't, he was very cross with them. I once heard him call a contemporary artist evil.
But it seems Cuffin did like one young contemporary artist, me, though I can't think why.
When I first saw any work by you, I said, that man knows how to draw. And I said to Cuffin, that man knows how to draw. And I think he'd already met you, and so he agreed with me.
As I travel through Cuffin's creative heartland, I'm getting increasingly nervous about painting a portrait in his style. At a time when most artists were using brushes, Cuffin became the master of the palette knife, a technique he used to depict the edginess of Snowdonia and Anglesey. I nearly always stick to brushes, so this is really going to test me. Well, I've got my palette there, I've got a bag full of tubes of oil paint, and I've got this little thing. A palette knife. They were all tools of choice for Sir Cuffin Williams. I don't know how I'm going to go doing a painting using this little thing, but he made an art of it. Today, I'm visiting Heaven and Nesta Jones at their Snowdonia farm.
I've been looking forward to this.
Heaven has kindly agreed to sit for his portrait, and boy, am I nervous.
January this year.
The Joneses knew Cuffin, and they loved the way he portrayed their Wales. They also happened to be the parents of another famous Welsh son, the opera superstar Bryn Terfel, and unsurprisingly, music runs in the family, a bit like myself.
You're very music, aren't you?
Yeah. I don't know where it all came from, but my parents were both from Wales and from Victorian times. They were, and everybody sang. Always did it, you know. Yes. So I was always surrounded by music.
Yeah. Still the same. Heaven is in the male voice choir, and I'm with the ladies choir. Yeah. Keeping the tradition up.
Lovely, lovely.
Yes. Lovely.
You've got a great smiling face. I can't wait to paint you.
Oh.
It's a Cuffin Williams colour, that shirt, isn't it?
Oh, is it? Oh, good. Yeah. Worth a lot, then.
I don't know about that. So can you show me where I can change into my painting gear?
Yes.
You lead off. You lead the way. Lead on.
Okay.
What you really need to understand is that Cuffin created at least two big oil paintings a week.
dark brownie purple.
52 weeks of the year using a palette knife.
Background.
Oh, by the way, this is the first time I've ever painted a portrait with a palette knife, and I could end up with egg on my face here.
Cuffin would have loved to have painted you, you know, because he loved painting people from the local community. Your face will be somewhere here, and that'll be going down there, and then the rest of it's pretty dark down there, and perhaps a little bit of that brownie colour in there. I wish I could get the colours so flat and so orderly and ordered and in their right position the way Cuffin did. All I'm going to try and do is get some of the colours for your face a little bit, get some red into that, just underneath there. Lovely. I'm floundering at the moment a little bit. I don't know whether I'm getting it right until I've gone much further with it than I have so far, but gosh, it's not as easy as one might have imagined by looking at the ease with which Cuffin Williams did it.
I'm taking my time to finish off the rest of Heaven's portrait, but Cuffin would always rush back to his studio with his sketches and finish his painting in just one go. Remarkable. John Smith helped care for Cuffin in the last years of his life, a life that revolved around his studio.
We've got a magic day for it, isn't it? Brilliant sunlight out there. But when I come in here to this studio, when I came before, he had everything dark. He used to paint in here with it almost pitch black. What was the reason for that?
He suffered from epilepsy, which probably developed as a child, but became worse when he was in London. This made him sensitive to light. He was on medication, and that's the reason that it affected his vision.
It affected his ability to cope with bright sunlight.
Yes. And consequently, his paintings gradually became darker.
Because he didn't used to go out in the mountains when it was sunny, did he?
Not
at
all.
He wanted it to be wet, dingy and
cloudy, rain, wind,
snow.
I saw him in hospital. I went to see him, and eventually, after about an hour, I was about to leave. And I went through the door, and for some weird reason, I just felt that I probably wouldn't see him again.
Very emotional. Thinking about all our loss, you know.
It's a pity you hadn't known him sort of 10 years before. I felt the other day, I was thinking about this. You could have put a wonderful exhibition on together, the two of you.
We could have gone painting together, which I would have loved.
Yeah.
It's been an incredibly emotional day, but life-affirming too. This visit has really helped me to reconnect with my old friend Cuffin. Cuffin said that he painted for excitement and never really thought he would ever make it as an artist. But standing here in his old studio, I honestly think he's done more for the visual arts in Wales than any other artist. I'm now in the heart of the place that inspired Cuffin more than anywhere else, Snowdonia. Although I was proud to call Cuffin a friend, there are still lots of things I don't know about him as an artist. To help me, I've asked his best pal, Derek Seward Morgan, to join me up Snowdon. Derek is also the world authority on the life and the art of Sir Cuffin.
I know my wife and I have always loved seeing his work in the Royal Academy. We would make a beeline to that room and go, and be stunned and amazed. Yeah. Why did he return to Wales after so long away?
By the mid-70s, he had sold enough to have confidence to come back to Wales and be a full-time professional painter.
Do you think his paintings have an effect on the way people see their surroundings here in Wales?
Oh, yes. Having looked at Cuffin canvases for a while before coming up the mountain, you come up the mountain and you see the mountain Cuffin-esque, not in nature, but through Cuffin's eyes. And I always think that is a mark of a good artist.
How lovely, yeah.
What's your lasting memory of the man?
Oh, I have no doubt about that. Every time I've been to an exhibition of his, I always thought that I would like also to put Cuffin on show for people to see that glorious moustache and the brilliant blue-grey eyes that depicted Wales in such a brilliant manner.
Diolch.
OK.
Diolch yn fawr.
Oh, wow, wow, wow.
Iawn.
It's that
bwrw.
Swirly rain that comes from every direction and gets everywhere.
I'm really gutted that the weather's just too bad for me to sketch up here. But I doubt that these conditions ever forced Cuffin to stop painting. So I'm back down the mountain now, and I know exactly what'll cheer me up.
Now, the ladies of the harem of the court of King Caractacus were just passing by altogether. Now, the ladies of the
noses, you can remember noses. Now, the noses on the faces of the ladies of the harem of the court of King Caractacus were just passing by altogether. Now, the noses on the faces of the ladies of the harem of the court. It's no good crying.
Now, the noses on the faces of the ladies of the harem of the court of King Caractacus. Just move your mouth in time with the music.
To put the powder on the noses of the faces of the ladies of the harem of the court of King Caractacus. You're too late!
Too late!
Because they've just passed by!
Oh dear. They might have coped a little better with Jake the Peg, possibly. Thankfully, the weather does improve, though, so I can whip out my sketchbook at one of Cuffin's favourite spots in Snowdonia. I'm really starting to see this inspirational landscape through his eyes now. Time to return to my portrait of Bryn Terveld's dad, Hevin. For me, this is a labour of love for Cuffin, so I want to do him proud.
Get it on that edge of the palette knife so I can actually draw with it. That goes down there. At a later time, that's going to be that brilliant gleaming white down that edge. And this darkness is going to come in under here. I think under the edge of the hair, woof, like that. Yeah, woof, woof. Yes, I think that works. Yeah, that works.
You're pleased with yourself.
Well, that worked. You see, that little bit worked. It just worked. A couple of little lines of darkness on the shirt there. I've got you looking about 22 years old here. Is that okay with you?
Yeah, it's fine with me, yes.
It's almost the same as your shirt colour. That's great. Yeah, that's nice. You've got such an infectiously smiling face. You cheer people up just looking at you. I don't know whether you know all these things, do you?
You know, you're very kind.
I'll just put a different colour in there. I've started to get the measure of how to do it, nowhere near as good as the master, but I've got an idea. You know, he's obviously not pussyfooting about. He's not scraping the palette knife over the dry canvas. He's putting on great swathes of thick colour.
Cuffin was inspired by local characters. Like me, he loved painting people. Last year, I had the honour of opening an exhibition of his portraits here at the Cuffin Williams Gallery in Llangefni. They're fantastic. What a treat.
What's remarkable about these portraits is that they're done in the same sweeping style as he's done his landscapes, with a palette knife and quantities of thick, thick paint. Even the great man himself struggled a bit. as he says, every portrait I've painted has been a considerable strain. Nothing comes easily to me. That's a shock, isn't it? But I believe that some of my best work has been of the many interesting faces I've painted. And you'd have to agree with him.
Relationship one has with one's sitter, it invariably creates a tension which isn't there with a landscape. I do like painting portraits. I find it immensely difficult. Because it's so difficult, it is so tremendously worthwhile.
For me, this is one of Cuffin's best portraits. The subject is Evan Roberts, a remarkable blind botanist from Capel Carrig. It's magical. I'm meeting Evan's son, Eon, to find out more.
Why do you think Cuffin chose your dad?
Somebody had mentioned Evan Roberts to him, and
yeah,
he got very interested and started delving into his life. And next thing we knew, he came up and started painting.
Was he happy with your dad as a subject?
No, he got
no.
No, he got quite annoyed with my father.
Why?
Because he was always moving, blind.
Yeah.
Couldn't see, and if Cuffin was talking to him, he'd do that, you know, move his head, and that's exactly how the painting is.
I understand he became a very respected botanist.
Oh yes, worldwide.
Worldwide.
Yes.
It's amazing, isn't it, that a man from a little house here in the middle of Wales gets this worldwide reputation.
Yes, and all self-taught.
Very inspiring.
Yeah, he had no schooling, hardly any schooling. He hated the school.
What did you think of the portrait?
Beautiful.
Is that the dad that you knew?
Sorry.
Yeah, I feel the same. Give us a cooch. It's very emotional, isn't it?
Yeah. I lived all my life with him.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sorry.
Come on. He's up again.
Cuffin was passionate about teaching local kids to draw, and he passed on those fantastic skills throughout his life. And like Cuffin, I believe the future of art in this country lies with the younger generation.
They don't often look happy and smiling in a portrait.
Children need to learn the basics. It's as simple as that.
Slabs of colour across the background with put on with a knife. They were all done by Sir Cuffin Williams. Really good, isn't it?
Oh, look at the teeth you've got, Tessie.
How many teeth is that? 312 teeth in that fella's mouth. Hey, that's a good one, Josh, with a smile. Look at that. Lovely. That's very good. Good one, Ossian. Lovely. You've got another 4 million teeth now. Gosh, look at the hair.
I can't believe how talented these kids are. Cuffin would have been blown away. Enough drawing for now. Time for a tune about a Welsh sheepdog who bit me on the backside.
Do you want to learn a song?
Yeah.
Okay, I've written a special song for you today. So in Welsh it goes, Ki maur, ki maur di dang os ailanedd, troi redeg. Ki maur, ki maur di, breath of them henol. Is that good?
Yeah.
Did you understand my Welsh then?
Yeah.
Did you? Oh, that's a relief. One, two, one, two, three, four. Ki maur, ki maur di dang os aidhanedd, troi redeg. Di maur, ki maur di, breath of them henol. Very good. That was a good shout at the end.
I know how much teaching drawing meant to Cuffin. He would have got such a kick out of today.
Drawing, like painting and other art forms, is an act of appreciation and love. And as long as people enjoy the world around them, it will always be an act of devotion.
Gosh, it's so hard not to miss the man. As I follow in Cuffin's footsteps, I can see why this land was so inspirational to him.
Cuffin's wails. Oh, shut up, will you, sheep? I'm trying to do a piece to camera. There are things about Cuffin's wails which have changed beyond recognition. But in other ways, time has stood still. The farmsteads are still here, together with the families that have worked this land for generations.
I guess that's why I wanted to paint Bryn Terveld's farmer dad, Evin, because he's just the type of Welshman Cuffin loved to paint.
Oh, come on. Now sit.
I'm starting to feel quite happy about this.
Feel?
Which is a great relief, because I was very nervous before I started as to whether I would be able to do it, you know?
Hmm. Have you met Cuffin yourself?
I met him, yes.
Oh, yes.
Gee, what a nice man. And we got on like a house on fire, you know. We sort of admired the same things, I think.
Yeah.
Nid oingo rinbo with moith is hirebid nai berlai mai.
He's doing harmony, you or me?
Gavin oi.
Am galon hapis calon on es calon lan. Calon lan yn llawn daioni. Tecach iwn a lili los, dim ond calon lanath gani, can i'r dydd a can i'r nos.
Good. dear. Yes! Come and have a look and see what you think, Evin.
Well, okay.
Oh.
That's really good.
Does it capture you, do you
yes,
think?
Yes. I'm a bit older, maybe, but...
A bit taller?
Older.
Older! I thought you said taller. Where's that dangerous lady of yours?
Yes, I've been watching you.
Have you?
Yes.
I wasn't aware of you there.
Maybe the one that's first that congratulates you on the job.
Thank you very much.
Very good painting. Yes.
Well, it's been wonderful learning more about Sir Cuffin Williams and about his life and about his work. It's been incredibly emotional at times and massively challenging towards the end here, trying to work in a palette knife and do a portrait with a palette knife. I really hope that as a friend and as a fellow artist, he would have appreciated my homage to him, to a great, great Welshman who was sadly missed. Was the most difficult bit of all.
Rolf's back at the same time next week, and to find out how you can go and see the paintings, head to bbc.co.uk/Wales and click on Arts.